A moment ago, you said that you ordered Lieutenant Kendrick to tell his men that Santiago wasn't to be touched.
That's right.
And Lieutenant Kendrick was clear on what you wanted?
Crystal.
Any chance Lieutenant Kendrick ignored the order?
Ignored the order?
Any chance he forgot about it?
No.
Any chance Lieutenant Kendrick left your office and said, the old man is wrong?
No.
When Lieutenant Kendrick spoke to the platoon and ordered them not to touch Santiago, any chance they ignored him?
You ever served in an infantry unit, son?
No, sir.
Ever served in a forward area?
No, sir.
Ever put your life in another man's hands? Asked him to put his life in yours?
No, sir.
We follow orders, son. We follow orders or people die. It's that simple. Are we clear?
Yes, sir.
Are we clear?
Crystal. Colonel, I have just one more question before I call Airman O'Malley and Airman Rodriguez. If you gave an order that Santiago wasn't to be touched, and your orders are always followed, then why would Santiago be in danger? Why would it be necessary to transfer him off the base?
Santiago was a substandard Marine. He was being transferred.
That's not what you said. You said he was being transferred because he was in grave danger.
That's correct.
You said he was in danger. I said grave danger. You said, is there any
other... I recall what I said.
I can have the court reporter read back to you.
I know what I said. I don't have to have it read back to me like I'm...
Why the two orders? Colonel?
Sometimes men take matters into their own hands.
No, sir. You made it clear just a moment ago that your men never take matters in their own hands. Your men follow orders or people die. So Santiago shouldn't have been in any danger at all, should he have, Colonel?
You snotty little bastard.
Your Honor, I'd like to ask for a recess.
I'd like an answer to the question, Judge.
The court will wait for an answer.
If Lieutenant Kendrick gave an order that Santiago wasn't to be touched, then why did he have to be transferred? Colonel? Lieutenant Kendrick ordered the code red, didn't he? Because that's what you told Lieutenant Kendrick to do.
Object!
And when it went bad, you cut these guys loose!
Your Honor,
you had Marcus inside a bony transport!
Your Honor,
you doctored the logbook!
Damn it, Captain!
You coerced the doctor!
Consider yourself in contempt!
Colonel Jessup, did you order the code red?
You don't have to answer that question.
I'll answer the question. You want answers?
I think I'm entitled to.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth! Son, we live in a world that has walls, and those walls have to be guarded by men with guns. Who's gonna do it? You? You, Lieutenant Weinberg? I have a greater responsibility than you can possibly fathom. You weep for Santiago and you curse the Marines. You have that luxury. You have the luxury of not knowing what I know, that Santiago's death, while tragic, probably saved lives. And my existence, while grotesque and incomprehensible to you, saves lives. You don't want the truth because deep down in places you don't talk about at parties, you want me on that wall. You need me on that wall. We use words like honor, code, loyalty. We use these words as the backbone of a life spent defending something. You use them as a punchline. I have neither the time nor the inclination to explain myself to a man who rises and sleeps under the blanket of the very freedom that I provide and then questions the manner in which I provide it. I would rather you just said thank you and went on your way. Otherwise, I suggest you pick up a weapon and stand a post. Either way, I don't give a damn what you think you are entitled to.
Did you order the code red?
I did the job.
Did you order the code red?
You're goddamn right I did!
Please the court, I suggest the members be dismissed so that we can move to an immediate Article 39A session. The witness has rights.
Captain Ross.
Jack?
The members of the court will retire to an anteroom until further instructed.
All rise.
What the hell is this?
Colonel, what's going on? I did my job. I do it again. I'm gonna get on a plane and go on back to my base.
You're not going anywhere, Colonel. MPs guard the Colonel.
Yes, sir.
Captain Ross.
What the hell is this?
Colonel Jessup, you have the right to remain silent. Any statement
I'm being charged with a crime.
A trial by court-martial.
Is that what this is?
Or administrative.
I'm being charged with a crime.
You have the right to consult with a lawyer prior to any further questioning.
This is funny.
This lawyer may be a civilian.
That's what
lawyer
this is.
By you at
this
your
is.
Own expense.
I'm gonna rip the eyes out of your head and piss in your dead skull. You fucked with the wrong Marine.
Colonel Jessup, do you understand these rights as I've just read them to you?
You fucking people. You have no idea how to defend a nation. All you did was weaken a country today, Caffey. That's all you did. You put people's lives in danger. Sweet dreams, son.
Don't call me son. I'm a lawyer and an officer in the United States Navy. And you're under arrest, you son of a bitch. The witness is excused.